Hello students, I welcome you all in the next lecture of Mathematics 1. I hope you all are doing well at home. Praying for the good health of everyone, now let us begin with our lecture. We are studying chapter number 1, Sets, and in that we have completed the introduction of sets, and then we have seen the methods to write sets, two methods, that they are listing method and set builder form or rule method. In the previous lecture we have seen types of sets. You can recall them. They are singleton set, means the set with single element or one element, then empty set or null set, the set with no element. Then finite set, the set with countable elements or limited elements, we can say. And then infinite set, the set with uncountable elements or unlimited elements. Based on that, we have seen practice set 1.2. We have completed that. Now, let us go towards the next topic, that is Venn diagrams. Okay, so Venn diagrams were given by the mathematician John Venn. You can see in your textbook this information about the mathematician John Venn is given. The birth year is 1834 and he died in 1923. Okay, so he gave the information about logic and probability. Or for these words logic and probability, he gave the mathematical form. And he is famous for his book Logic by Chance. So John Venn was the mathematician who gave the idea about Venn diagrams. That is why after his name they are called as what? Venn diagrams. You can say that this is one more way of representing the set. Okay, as we have seen two methods, listing method and set builder form, but there we used to write it in the curly bracket, but here the set is derived or written by using the geometric figures, or it is all types of figures are used. You can use triangle, you can use circle, you can use oval shape, you can use freehand sketch, like you know you are in science, you are drawing amoeba. So that also you can draw. So any type of figure you can draw, and in that figure you have to write down the elements of set. Anywhere you can write down. And within that set you have to write down the name of that set by using the capital alphabet. For example, here A is a set having 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So here we have drawn oval shape and in that we have shown those elements. And A is written inside. Okay, so it is a set A. So such diagrams are called as what? Venn diagrams. As I have said, you can use any figure, triangle, rectangle, square, you can use circle, or you can draw a freehand sketch also. These Venn diagrams are very, very useful when we solve the word problems. You will understand when we will go towards the last part of the topic, that how important Venn diagrams are. Now here the limitation of Venn diagram is what? We cannot show infinite set here. Like in curly brackets we are writing dot 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 dot. So it is not possible. Here Venn diagram is applicable only for the finite set. Or when we solve the word problems by using the number of elements that in that set, we can solve the problems very easily. Okay. Let us take one more example of Venn diagram here. B is a set of all x such that x is greater than or equal to minus 10 and less than or equal to 0. And the condition given is what? X is an integer. Okay, that means here you have to write down the integers from minus 10 to 0. You can write in any sequence. Now they are written in sequence here: 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9 and minus 10. and the name of the set is written inside. Okay, now here rectangle is used. So any diagram you can draw, but as I have said, it is not useful for showing infinite set. Okay, so this was about Venn diagram. Now let us go further. Now we are going to study the important concept of subset. Okay, now when we think of subset, we have to think of minimum two sets, okay, A or B or P or Q, anything, but we require minimum two sets, then only we can understand the concept of subset. Okay, so let us take one simple example and try to understand the concept of subset. Okay, so here I am taking the example of two sets. Set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. And set B is having 4 elements, 2, 4, 6 and 8. Okay, here the continuous numbers are given. Consecutive numbers are given from 1 to 8. And in B, you can see that only even numbers are there. Now, what I can say is 2 is present in B and it is present in A also. See, 4 is present in B and it's present in A also. Similarly, I can say for 6 and 8 also. So, what I can say, all the elements of B are present in A. Okay, in that case, I will say that B is a subset of A. Okay, so how we are going to define it? If A and B are the two given sets and every element of set B is also an element of set A, then we say that B is a subset of A. Symbolically, we are going to write it like this. B is a subset of A. This is a symbol of subset. Okay, this U is written in the horizontal manner and below that one line is drawn. This is a symbol of subset. Okay, so how we are going to read it? B is a subset of A, or simply you can say B subset A. Okay, here you cannot say that A is subset of B. See here, subset is always a smaller set. So here A is bigger and B is smaller and all the elements of B are present in A. So we can say that B is subset of A, but A is not subset of B. You cannot write it in reverse way. Always while writing this, you have to keep in mind the smaller set that you are going to write first, then symbol and then the bigger set. Okay. Now suppose the two sets are equal. We have seen the concept of equal sets. Then we can say that they are subsets of each other. But here in this case, they are not subsets of each other. B is subset of A, but A is not a subset of B. Okay. Now here, then you will think what A is called as. So A is called as superset. If B is subset, then A is superset. Okay. Now if we want to represent it by using Venn diagram, then how we are going to represent it? See, A is drawn outside, which is bigger set. And inside that one more smaller set is drawn, because all the elements of B are in A. That means B is completely inside A. That is why B is drawn inside A. See here. Okay. So the elements of B, that is 2, 4, 8 and 6, they are written here. And remaining elements from set A, they are written here outside B. That is 1. 3, 5 and 7. We are not going to repeat it again because set A contains 8 elements which are here. Okay, out of that 4 elements are inside B. So remaining 4 you have to write down outside B. Okay, so in this way you are going to show subset by using Venn diagram. So why I can say that B is subset of A? Because every element of set B is also an element of set A. And therefore, I can write B is a subset of A. I cannot say A is a subset of B. Okay? A is called as superset, B is called as subset, and here you have to draw the Venn diagram like this. Always the bigger set, and inside that you have to draw the subset. Then elements of subset you write down, and the remaining elements you write down outside that subset. Okay, let us go further. Let us see one more example now. Okay, so example number 2 is N is equal to set of natural numbers. You know that capital N stands for natural numbers, and I is set of integers. Now think whether N is subset of I or I is subset of N. Natural numbers, they start from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. And in integers, you have negative numbers, positive numbers and 0 also. So think now, can I be the subset of N? No. What we can say, N is a subset of I, because all the elements of N are present in I. Okay. How you are going to write it? Here, N is subset of I, because all the natural numbers are integers. Okay. You cannot write I is subset of N. You cannot write it in reverse way, because all integers are not natural numbers. But all natural numbers are integers. Think of the expansion of integers. That negative numbers on left hand side, 0 is in the middle, and positive numbers are on the right hand side. So all the positive numbers, they are nothing but what? Natural numbers. Okay. So natural numbers are integers. Therefore, N is subset of I. Okay. Let us go further. Let us take one more example. Third example here. P is a set of all x such that x is a square root of 25. This is one set given in set builder form or rule method, and one more set is given in rule method. S is set of all y such that y belongs to I, means integers, and y is between or equal to minus 5 and 5. Okay. So now let us write down these sets as the list method. Okay, so first we will write P. So square root of 25, you know that every square has two roots. One is positive and other is negative. Okay, so set P contains two elements, minus 5 and 5. And here you have to write down all the integers including minus 5 and 5. So they will be minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now look at these two sets and decide which is a subset of which. See, S is too big. Think of P. Are the elements of P present in S? Yes. See, minus 5 is present in P. It is present in S also. Plus 5 is present in P and it is present in S also. So here all the elements of set P are present in S. Therefore I can say that P is a subset of S. Every element of P is also an element of set A. Therefore I can say that P is a subset of S. Always keep in mind that the smaller set you are going to write first. Then the symbol of subset, that is U, you have to write down in horizontal way, and below that the line, and then the bigger set, or the other word is superset. Okay. Now let us remember the important points regarding subset. What we can say, the very first property is every set is a subset of itself. That means A is a subset of A, obviously, because if we think of A, then all the elements of A are there in A. So every set is a subset of itself. Second thing, empty set is a subset of every set. You know that empty set is denoted by this symbol phi. So we can say that phi is a subset of every set because it is empty. Okay, so every set is going to have the empty space. That is why here empty set is subset of every set. You have to keep in mind this because they are asked in MCQs. You know the paper pattern now. Question number 1A is MCQ, and in MCQs, such questions are asked. They will ask you, state whether the statement is true or false. So, here you have to keep in mind all these things. Then the next one, third property here. If A is equal to B, means if we think of the equal sets, then we can say that A is subset of B and B is subset of A. Means equal sets are subsets of each other. This is third property. Then the next one, if A is subset of B, then we can, and B is subset of A, then we can say that A is equal to B. Now see, statement number 4 is converse of statement number 3. You know the word converse now. In geometry, you have studied these words. What is statement and what is converse? Okay. So here you can see that you will see two words, if and then. So here if, after if the condition is given, and then here the statement is given, means after then the statement is given. So if A is equal to B is written here after if, and here A is equal to B is written after then. Okay, so here this way you can see that these statements are interchanged. They are called as what? Converse of each other. See here, if A is equal to B, then A is subset of B and B is subset of A. Or what we can say, if A is subset of B and B is subset of A, then A is equal to B. Okay, that means if two sets are equal, they are subsets of each other. And if they are subsets of each other, then the sets are equal. Okay, so these are called as converse statements. I hope you must have understood these properties. Now, let us go towards the next examples or more examples. If A is equal to 1, 3, 4, 7 and 8. A is a set where we have 5 elements. And then you have to write down all possible subsets of A. Okay. This is textual question. So I am discussing it according to the textbook only. Okay. Now in textbook they have given you few examples of subsets here. Okay. Few examples are given. See, P is one subset which is given, which contains two elements 1 and 3. T is given, which contains three elements 4, 7, 8. V contains 1, 4 and 8. S contains 1, 4, 7, 8. So, okay, so they have given four subsets. But what is the question here? Write all possible subsets. Now you will think that how many such subsets we can write. So how to find out the answer, number of sets? Here you have to count the number of elements. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 5 elements are there. Then you will find 2 raised to 5. Means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 5 times. 2 you are going to multiply by itself 5 times. Then the answer will be 32. See, 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 8. 8 into 2, 16. And 16 into 2, 32. So if you multiply 2 5 times, you are going to get the answer 32. So here, you are going to get 32 subsets for this. Okay, you can make use of the properties now which we have seen. What was the first property there? That every set is a subset of itself. That means this set is having 5 elements. So that is subset. Then one is null set. That is also subset. Then you can write down 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 singleton sets. That means set with single elements. 1, then 3, then 4. Then 7, then 8. Okay, so singleton sets how many? 5 and those 2, 7. Then you can write down the set with element 2. That is 1, 3, 1, 4, 1 7, 1 8, then 3 4, 3 7, 3 8, then 4 7, 4 8, and finally 7 8. So all these sets are with the element 2 elements. Then you can write down the set with 3 elements, 1 3 4, correct? Then 1 3 7, 1 3 8. Then you can write down 1 4 7. Okay. Then you can write down 1 4 8, which is present here. Then you can write down 1 7 8. So this way you can write down the elements with sets with 3 elements, and then you can write down the set with 4 elements. Okay, that means 1 2 3 4. Sorry, 1 3 4 7. Then 1 3 4 8. Then 1 3 7 8. So this way you can write down the set with 4 elements, and finally the set itself. So in this way, it is possible for you to write down 32 such sets. Okay, so all of you, please try it. Start with empty set or null set. Then write down singleton sets. Then write down set with 2 elements. Then write down set with 3 elements. Then write down set with 4 elements. And finally, the set itself with 5 elements. In this way, you can write 32 sets here. I hope all of you will try it. Okay. Let us go further. Next example. Here they have provided you with certain sets. Okay. Some sets are given below. See, set A is given here. And here it is infinite from both the sides. And you have -4, -2, 0, 2, 4, 6. That means you have multiples of 2 here. All positive as well as negative multiples. Then set B is given. Here you have 1, 2, 3, 4. That means natural numbers are given. Then here set C is given, where you have elements again infinite from both the sides. And here you will observe that all these are multiples of 6. See, 6 zeros are 6, 6 zeros are 0, 6 ones are 6, 6 into -1 is -6, 6 twos are 12, 6 into -2 is -12. So you can see these are multiples of 6. Here you will observe that these are multiples of 4. And here you will observe that this set of integers is provided. Okay. So now they have asked you that out of these 2 statements, which are true? Okay, so let us see the first one. A is a subset of B, C and D. Okay, now think of A and B first. Check whether all the elements of A are there in B. No. See, here negative numbers are there. And here the set is of natural numbers. So elements of A are not present in set B. So we cannot say that A is subset of B. Also, you can check for C. See, here -2 is present. But here in set C, -2 is not there. Similarly, -2 is not an element of D. So that means statement A is false. It is not true. Okay. Then next, B is a subset of all the sets which are given above. Means what? Every element of B is present everywhere. Means if we think of 1, it should be present in A, it should be present in C, it should be present in D, it should be present in I. So see, 1 is present here. No. 1 is not present here also. 1 is not present here also. 1 is present here. We can say that B is subset of I. But it is not subset of all the sets. So again, this statement is false. It is not true. Every element of that smaller set should be present here. Like if we think of 1, then one is not present in this set. So B cannot be a set. Okay, even 2 is not present, 3 is not present. So here it is present in I. If they say that B is subset of I, it's correct. You can say that A is subset of I. You can see that C is subset of I. You can say that D is subset of I, because I is a set of integers, and you will observe that all these are integers. But now in this case, both the statements are false. They are not true. Okay, I hope you must have understood these sums. They are solved examples from the textbook. Now let's go further. Related to the subset, now we will try to understand one more concept, which is called as universal set. Okay, so for universal set, I will give you the simple example. In our school, we have the sports day or sports week we have, and in that sports week there are various sports you are playing, like you are playing kabaddi, you are playing kho kho, then you are playing langdi. Okay, then some individual games also are there. So when you think of a team, like if you want to prepare a volleyball team, kabaddi team or kho kho team or langdi team, you know that your sports are inter-house. Four houses are there, na? Yellow, red, then green and blue. Now you must be missing your sports week or PT period when I am reminding you all these things. So when you think of making a team, suppose you are in yellow house, then for the team, you are going to think only about the students of yellow house. You will not think of students of green house. Okay, so from yellow house only you will prepare one team for volleyball, one team from kabaddi, one team for kho kho, one team for langdi. Okay, that means for all the these four teams, you thought of only the students of yellow house. So here the students of yellow house, they are nothing but what? Universal set. Okay, so yellow house is going to become universal set, and all the teams like kabaddi, kho kho, langdi and volleyball, they are going to become subset because you are taking the students from yellow house. Okay, similarly green house will think of green house only. So in this way, the bigger set and under which all the subset we are thinking about, if they are subsets of that, then that bigger set is called as what? Universal set. Okay, or think of your school library. Your school library is a universal set, and in that library you have various books, like drama book is one set, poetry book is one set, then textbook is one set. So different kinds of books, they will be the subsets, and library is what? Universal set. Okay, so this way, if when you think of a bigger set and under which all the sets are subsets, then we can say that that bigger set is a universal set. How you are going to write down the definition now? That you have to think of a bigger set which will accommodate all the given set under consideration, which in general is known as universal set. Just now I gave you the example of your house, green house or yellow house, and you are making teams. So those teams will be subsets and your house students will be universal set. Okay, so the sets which are under consideration, they are called as what? Subsets of universal set. Let us take one example here. Okay, so here also one example is discussed. Suppose we want to study the students in class 9 who frequently remain absent. That means what? We want to find out the absent students from class 9. Okay, so then we are going to think of only class 9. We will not think of class 8. Because we want to find out the students, those who remain absent from class 9. So here we are going to think of class 9 only. So here the students from all the divisions, like we have A, B, C. So those all students will become universal set. Got it? And from that, if we find out absent students, then those absent students will be, they will become the subset of this set. That is the set of class 9, which we have think of universal set. Got it? So the bigger set is called as universal set. Okay? Let us see one more example here. A cricket team of 15 students is to be selected from a school. Now, cricket is a favorite game, and you know that our school is also having a very good cricket team. Okay? So, here when we think of a cricket team of 15 students and from the school, then we will think of the students, those who play cricket. We will not think of all the students. Only we will think of the students, those who play cricket, and from that we will find out the best 5 cricket players. Okay, so the students, those who play cricket, will be the universal set, and the selected team will become what? Subset. Okay, so you can represent it like this by using Venn diagram. Okay, what you have to keep in mind is, generally in Venn diagram, universal set is represented by rectangle. For universal set, we use rectangle. Okay. So, all students in the school, those who play cricket, that is our universal set, and the team of cricket players will become subset. Okay, so it is drawn inside that rectangle. We have seen the subset relationship there. Okay, so generally, universal set is shown by rectangle. And then, one more thing, for representing the universal set, always we use the letter U. U stands for universal set. So, universal set is always denoted by the letter capital U, and it is represented by rectangle. Okay, so whenever you will have the sums regarding universal set and you have to solve the problems, you will always represent universal set by the rectangle, and that U is written outside. You can see here. It is not written inside. For remaining sets, we saw that when we draw Venn diagrams, we are writing the name of the set inside. But here, universal set U is written outside. So, you have to keep in mind all these things. Okay. Now, the examples based on this universal set and more concepts related to that, we will discuss in next lecture. Okay. So, students, today we are stopping here. Till that, you stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself. Thank you, students.